Hello, guys, again. So, I'm Igor Chernov, and it's RPG Legends again, right? One of the rare gems, actually, in history. What I surprisingly never found, actually, in any top of any RPG top, actually, right? It's kind of funny, what not a lot of people actually talk about Sudeki ever. They think what this RPG is supposed to be kind of like not that good to just mention it at some point, right? But I think this game is a true hidden gem, actually, for a lot of people. Whatever you're just an JRPG player, action RPG player, CRPG player, doesn't matter, right? Because it's just pure... And just golden experience for anyone who just like to just have a great story, great characters, and yeah, with all this just JRPG, I don't know, just looking game, right? You expect to for the game to be like from the, you know, just from Japan developers or from the developers of the Japan, but it's basically an European development project made it. It's like with Climax Studio, I think it's an England studio, right? And it was the golden age of an Xbox, right? Both when Xbox with Xbox and Xbox 360, right? When Microsoft actually buying good developers, right, to just make a great game, and this game one of this golden era of Xbox. Not a lot of people actually remember this era for some reason. Because in America, for example, there's supposed to be a lot of people who just been huge fans of Earthbound or Marvel series, right? Or something like Final Fantasy. But they never mentioned Sudeki. I mean, look at all these JRPG or RPG experts, right? None of them even just mention it, right? So yeah, a lot of people will say what this game is not that good actually, right? And It's not even worth the effort, but I think it's one of the best RPG and action RPGs in history, actually, right? Since it's my top, right? It's my golden standard, I suppose, right? I totally understand what I'll just not to mention this game. I'll just as a one of the best RPGs in history, it's a crime, right? So Sudeki is an action RPG with Japanese looking style, right, but made by the Western developers from England, right? This game, it's like got this it's like this game is from that era where you actually, even if you just take something from other games, right, like just the way how the game looks completely like a JRPG and tried hard to be a JRPG, but it's not a JRPG, right? It's like semi tactical, semi action RPG game, right? Where you're supposed to have a combo system, right? And you got like different characters who are supposed to be we're supposed to have an different class, right? And yeah, you're not supposed to create a character, right? But it's because the character is supposed to be pre-created for you, right? Well, it's a story-based RPG, right? So, for example, Tal in this game, right? Are supposed to be a warrior, right? And Sorceress is supposed to be your just companion, right? And she got a completely different gameplay just compared to you. So, for example, if you just choose Sorceress, right? You're supposed to play something like a shooter game, you know? So, like, it's like not a lot of people remember this game, but it's supposed to be a game, an adaptation of books, which is Wheel of Time, right? And it's basically have the same name, actually, which is Wheel of Time. So it's basically, it's something like a like fantasy shooter, you know? It's like, not like Doom, but, it's something like Quake or Doom experience, you know, where you're supposed to run around, kill enemies, and, you know, and use some certain spells, I suppose, right? But in this game, how were just they made this new battle system is just it's kind of funny. What not any other RPG not supposed to copy paste this battle system, because I think this battle system is kinda special actually, right? And if I was a game developer, I'm supposed to just take all these ideas from Sudeiki. Like, for example, you got this combat system if you play a warrior, right? So, for example, you got two buttons, like one strike and second strike, like 1-2, right? So you basically can make a combo, like in regular slasher, for example, or any action game, right? Any action RPG game, like you just press two buttons, actually. It's supposed to be like one and two buttons, right? Like you press like two times one and one time second button, right? Which is you basically create a combo, right? Well, it's a simple system, right? Like you just press like light attack and heavy attack, right? Like light attack, heavy attack, right? Which is combo, obviously, right? But above that, if you want to use some super attack, right? Or special attack, right? You got the slow-mo screen, and you're supposed to just use it, right, in slow-mo, and you also got the range of the spell, right? You can totally see it, right? Where your enemies are supposed to be inflicted, right? This array, actually, right? Like, for example, you cast a fireball, right? Or just what in this game you can call a fireball, right? And if you just play sorceress, right, it's the same slow-mo for her, actually, right? And it's like, if you regularly as a sorceress play a first person, it feels like you play a first first face shooter. When you just got different gameplay from sorceress, right? It's the same with special attacks for everyone, right? Like you got this slow-mo, right? And you can just use this special attack, right? First person shooter, right? And it's like, you see, you just got two characters, right? Which is this sorceress and the guy who just use a science, right? Or just some sort of steampunk guns, right? Which is supposed to be kind of like look like laser guns, actually, right? But it's not a laser gun. Well, it's like this fantasy universe are supposed to be on the brink of steampunk and magic. Like, the people use and technology and magic both, and it's in all this weird, I don't know, just JRPG souls, I don't know, right? How the game looks, actually, right? I mean, look at the folder of the game, right? It's totally look like the if you see it first time, you'd be like, is this supposed to be a JRPG game? But it's not. Same goes with Jade Empire, right? For example, if you ever play Jade Empire, if you look at the folder, you will think what is Japanese game, but it's not. It's coming from the it's been made by Bauer, right? Canadian developers. So over RPGs, obviously, right? And this game is like the way how it just create this unique experience, what you just play in a Western game with Western dub, actually, right? Because all the don't even try to find this game in Japanese dub, actually, with Japanese dub, right? Because this game never been dubbed and never been voice acted for Japan. It's international, English game, actually, from England. It's not supposed to be even American, actually, right? And it's like, you see, it's kind of funny what this Climax Studio, comment back in the days, make a comment, right, about the Sudeiki 2, are supposed to just create the continuation of this game, and they'll be like, no, never. It's kind of funny, actually. maybe these people who just actually make this game, they already leave actually, right? Because it's never been that successful, right? Even in, it's like both and in West or in Japan, right? Because it's like just previous example of Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning, right? Even if the game got everything, it's not supposed to have a huge success among the people for some reason, right? And you got games like, I don't know, just Undertale, right? Was supposed to be kind of indie game, right? Was supposed to have this Earthbound to Mauer vibe, I suppose, right? But it's become extremely popular, even if it's supposed to be indie game, right? Or so-called indie game. But it's just got a huge success. So it's unpredictable, actually, every time, right? But this game is a huge success in the way of transcendence, in the way of how you just put this game as one of the best RPGs in history. Both and combat and story and music in this game are unique and special, right? The chemistry of this game are unique and special, right? And you see, it's like a lot of people actually mention a lot of kind of rare RPGs sometimes, right? It's okay when you just got examples like Arcanum, for example, right? Or Eye of Beholder. Well, it was back in the days, it was an old game, but you still can just feel this unique experience playing these RPGs, right? But for some reason, you see, it's like, Sudeikis is a pure hit game. You start to play it, and you'll be like, hell yeah, I'm home. This is a good old RPG for me. Even if you're supposed to be kind of bored at the beginning, you totally realize what this game is extremely special, right? It's like, yeah, it's not supposed to be, it's not supposed to have a modern look, right? But it still look, insanely good. And it's kind of funny, this game is extremely cheap on any platform. Steam or GOG, I suppose. But as far as I remember, you can only buy it on GOG, actually, which is good old games, right? On consoles, you're supposed to buy it just for Xbox, maybe, right? If you still got an Xbox, right? And I have no idea, actually. Have I got something like version for Xbox 360? But, the way how the game actually plays and feels is just something else, right? And it's like, Sudeikis create, it's like, you see, it's like, when you got like these games like Fable with their own atmosphere and aesthetics, what actually create this Fable unique experience game, right? You also supposed to just feel what Sudeikis game is also supposed to be extremely special and create its own genre even, right? It's not supposed to be like a JRPG. And it's not supposed to be like any other Western action RPGs, right? This game is kind of, is even got gore actually in this game, you know? And I was like, yeah, the character looks like, some people even mentioned what these characters look like, where it's supposed to be like some characters from hentai game, right? But it's not like this. That's what we like. And laugh about JRPGs, it's all these cool characters who actually look cool and bright, right? Yeah, for a lot of people it will be like beep style, anime style, but that doesn't matter actually, right? And the world of this game, what being both and extremely unique and special, right? And you totally understand what was supposed to be. It's not supposed to be an open world game, right? But it's like the locations in this game, right? From this bright, I don't know, just typical JRPG cities, right? To some locations would look like in dark fantasy, right? This game make you speechless actually at some point, right? Above that, you got all these JRPG elements, like you're supposed to find some unique, special, super weapon for every character, right? And you got a battle system. You got this, you got basically four different characters, and four different characters got a different gameplay, right? So, for example, in open world, right, you got Она уже с... Characters like Bookie, right? Она уже с this girl. Она уже с... With... Она уже с... Weapon like... A Wolverine, you know? From X-Men, right? With clothes, you know? And she's supposed to just use these clothes to just, get to some certain locations, like, right? Like you just, and I mean, mostly you expect this gameplay, like you're supposed to just travel on walls, right? I don't know, just, right? Like in God of War or in, I don't know, just Darksiders game, right? But it's... It's basically the core gameplay of Sudeikis, right? With different characters got the different gameplay, right? The sorcerers got this ability what she's supposed to dispel hidden objects, right? For example, you got a lot of secrets in this game, right? And to reveal all of them, you need to use four different characters, right? To just get this and secret loot and secret location, I suppose, right? You just try hard to find all of them, right? By using four of the different characters, right? And above that, you also got the different gameplay in, you know, it's like if you just if in fight, basically, right? If you battle somebody, right? So two characters got this shooter, first shooter mechanic, right? For first person shooter mechanic, like sorcerers and this guy with laser gun, right? And you got regular slasher or just action RPG gameplay. You it's like by using Tal, right? Or Buki, for example, right? And it's like, obviously, you can expect these typical action RPG bosses, right? Like, you got big bosses in the end of each dungeon or level, I suppose, like in regular slasher, right? But it's all become possible before the actual slasher, right? Genre become this popular, right? I mean, compare release of this game and Devil May Cry 3, for example, right? Or, I don't know, just any other slasher, like, I don't know, just like God of War, for example, right? Well, I mean, yeah, the origin of... you still have games like Prince of Persia, Warrior Within, which is kind of like an adventure game and slasher, or semi-slasher, I suppose. But, you know, it's like, you totally will get what I'm trying to say, actually, right? Because it's just, in every dungeon, you got, like, this big huge boss, right, at the end, right? And it's like, even if you just only go through where it's not an open world game, right? And you're supposed to you got this typical liner locations, right? But even if you just go through all of them, actually, right, this game still a fun to explore, actually, right? Because it's all got something inside of it, like these secrets, right? And it's like it will give you actually more fun experience than you actually want to have, right? Because this game is actually huge, to be perfectly honest, right? Right? Above that, you got also just all this typical stuff, like you're supposed to equip your characters, right? With weapons and armor, right? Some special weapons and armor. Some hidden, even, right? But it's not supposed to be typical JRPG experience, right? Where you're supposed to just grab every helmet in your city, right? It's kind of unique. You need an explore and equip from the... from any city what you're supposed to enter, right? And you also got this secret store, right? With dark creature, actually, right? In this game. Well, it's actually not that secret, right? But I mean, you're supposed to buy a special weapon what's supposed to cost you a lot of gold in this game, right? So what's that? And it's like, you see? The Sudeiki, having all these things inside of it, right? Like this different characters got different gameplay and just this ability system, right? When you, you know, just you got a slow-mo, right? You got this combat system, right? And with Buki and with Tal, actually, right? If you just control them, right? And you got this certain first-person shooter moments, right? If you just play Sorceress, right? You got like this regular attack was supposed to be kind of fast, and you got also different weapons was supposed to be and heavy, and it's like you're supposed to charge them, right, and release on just huge amount of damage, or just shoot it like in a regular shooter game, like on just you just shoot fast actually, right, with this, for example, regular weapon. So that's that, and you see, it's like. Even if it's supposed to be kind of like console game, right? It's okay to play it on PC, right? Because it's basically supposed to be a PC game, right? At the beginning, even if it's supposed to be ported from the Xbox. But we all know what Microsoft now, just sooner or later, they just remember what they also need to sell Windows, right? At some point, to some people like who just like to play on PC actually, right? And most of the PC games runs on Windows, right? Not all of them, obviously, right? Being ported, like Blue Dragon from Xbox 360 or Lost Odyssey, right? But as far as I understand, it's just hard to just for them to port these games, right? An original developer of Lost Odyssey, for example, right? They don't even bother actually to port these games to PC for their own reason. But the same goes with Climax Studios, right? And not only I, actually, a lot of people expect to have a Sudeki 2, right? Or to have an announcement, I don't know. Just, or Microsoft is supposed to just now just sponsor just inspire people by doing something like Sudeki, right? Or just by giving them money, right? But sadly, today Microsoft is not bad Microsoft, right? Not Microsoft from back in the days. What give you this masterpiece called Sudeki? Sudeki is totally just worth it to just, it's like, this game is totally worth it to just to name it one of the best RPGs in history, actually, right? That's why I just put it in RPG Legends, right? Again, don't bother to understand this series of podcast expectations what this are supposed to be kind of review, right? No, it's just my quick thoughts on best RPGs in history by my opinion, right? I mean, sound like I just try to justify myself actually, but to be perfectly honest, right, it's like I totally can guarantee what if you never play Sudeki, and if you played it for the first time, and you got the good sense of taste in RPG and above that in gaming actually, you totally love it, because Sudeki is just how it is. It's like, look at the folder of the game, it looks sexy, you know, this game is totally sexy. It's totally adorable, and it's like, if you never played it, you're free to try it, actually, right? I can guarantee what this game will be fun experience for you, right? And that's why Sudeki is just supposed to be one of these best RPGs in history, right? Of my list. In the list of RPG Legends, obviously, right? And Sudeki is just one of the an obvious hidden gems, right? If you can call it like that, actually, right? Because the game not supposed to be very popular among these people who love or JRPG or only CRPG. I, to be perfectly honest, like all RPGs, right? That's why I call myself a self proclaimed an RPG expert, right? Because I have no borders. And that's why I totally recommend Sudeki for anyone who like a good story, good music, good characters, and above that, I'll just like just to have a good game, actually, right? If you never played it, play it. 100% one of the best action RPGs in history.